The area of Korčula is a must-see for anybody visiting Croatia. The island contains numerous vineyards, olive orchards, tiny villages and communities. Because of its extensive woodlands, the earliest Greek inhabitants named it Korkyra Melaina, Black Korčula. The region is distinguished by an amazing town on the island, also known as Korčula, which is the island's principal town and features many magnificent marble streets and impressive structures. The mountainous coastline includes many calm beaches and little coves, whereas the northern shore is more level and has several natural harbours. Korčula's culture is still alive and well, with traditional religious sites and folk dance and music performances attracting an increasing number of visitors. Korčula is known for its wine, particularly the dessert wine created from grapes grown in the Lumbarda region. Korčula and Vela Luka on the west coast of the island are the two major ports. All ferries to Dubrovnik from Jadrolinija split stop at Korčula port. From June to September, Jadrolinija runs a daily passenger ferry between Split and Vela Luka, with a stop in Hvar, the island north of Korčula. The Krilo, a fast boat that cruises between Split and Korčula with a stop in Hvar, is also available. In the summer it runs every day, and from October to May it runs 3 to 5 times weekly. While you're enjoying these awesome drone shots, don't forget to like and subscribe and ring the bell. We are posting videos like this twice a week and we would hate for you to miss it. Away from the tourist places on the coast of the island Korčula, in the island's interior visitors discover a unique green landscape with panoramic views and hidden cultural treasure, which they can discover either on foot or by bicycle. The coast of the island of Korčula is very indented with a large numbers of bays and coves. Its north shore is rather low and easily accessible, with several natural harbors sheltered from the southern and easterly winds: Korčula, Banja, Račišće, Vrbovica, Babina, Prigradica. The south shore is more indented but steep in places, with cliffs rising up to 30 meters out of the sea in places. The main attraction is Korčula town itself, with its historic center of narrow alleys and crenellated walls. Except for its historical heritage, Korčula is also a great place for summer holidays, as it offers a warm sea, a lot of sun and lovely beaches. There are several beaches around the old town and numerous more around the island for one to enjoy. The Abbey of San Marcos, located near the church, is well worth seeing. The Dalmatian art room includes an amazing collection of paintings, and the entryway is ornamented with a collection of icons. The city museum is located across the street from the sanctuary in Gabriele's palace. Korčula's history and culture begin with a stone plaque marking the island's historic Greek occupation. The stone carving collection, which includes sculptures and artisan tools, depicts the evolution of this art, while the sailing room displays equipment and models from local vessels. There is also an archaeological section with prehistoric artifacts and a prehistoric furniture, textiles and portraiture art collection. Take a look at the beautifully designed Palace Arneri, which is located close to the museum, before leaving the area. The structure is located on the same named street. Marco Polo is claimed to have been born in Korčula in the year 1254. You may climb up the tower of his ostensible home for very little money. In addition, there is an icon museum. It's not quite a museum, but it does include some fascinating Byzantine icons painted on wood, gold backdrops and ritual artifacts. The museum's visitors are rewarded with the opportunity to visit the beautiful historic and neighboring church of All Saints.